Well, hello, beautiful creators. Welcome back to Mons on Media. Today I wanted to talk to you about layers in Canva. Now, layers in Canva is very different from, say, Photoshop, Affinity Photo, Pixlr, where they have dedicated layers palettes. Now, Canva's a little bit more old school and, frankly, very basic, where you basically have the front and the background and everything in between. Now, if you look in the screen here, I've got three basic shapes: the square in the background, the triangle in the foreground, and the purple circle in between them. Now, the way it works is super simple. All you have to do is right click on the element and you're going to have two options here: to send backward or send to back. Backward, it sends it backward one step. So if I move this circle, it's still in front of the square, but behind the purple circle. The other option you have is to send it to the very back, and that's what send to back is. So if I send this to the very back, now it's going to be behind the blue square. Now, bringing it to the front and bringing it forward works the same way. If I were to right click and bring it forward, it just brings it in front of the blue square there, but still behind the purple circle. But if I were to choose bring to front, now it's going to bring it all the way to the front. So very basic, very simple and easy to follow. Now, keeping all of that in mind, this is basically how I created this thumbnail for this video. And I want to run through step by step how I came about creating this thumbnail. Now, this applies to your social media posts, if you're creating a poster, or whatever it is you're designing, these concepts still apply. Also, everything you see here, I'm going to leave the keyword search terms when you're searching for them in Canva, should you want to follow along. So I started with this image, and we're going to click on the image and click on Edit Image and click on the Background Remover. Obviously, this is only available for Canva Pro, but you can remove the background using Pixlr's free background remover or even Remove BG. I'll leave links in the description below for those as well. So what I'm going to do here is increase the size of the image slightly. And following the whole rule of thirds concept that we talked about in the previous video, I'm just going to line it up here. I'm going to lock it just to prevent any movement or anything like that. Then we have our background image here, which I'm just gonna copy and paste. So now we have our foreground and our background elements. For the most part, you can add some text and consider it done, but we wanna spice it up just a little bit by using these layered concepts. So the first idea I had, I wanted something coming out of this character's hands, like a fireball or something glowing. So I searched for glowing sphere and came across this element, which I thought was really cool. This one is called a blue glowing sphere lightning. So search for that and you should find it within the elements. And I placed it in a way where it looks like it's coming out of this character's hands, right? But it still looked like it needed something else. So what I wanted to do was kind of do like an overlay effect. And this is where this element comes into play here. I'm going to bring the transparency up so you can see it in full here. And the name for this is Starburst in Space. And I pictured having this behind the glowing sphere. So we're gonna bring this over here and place it. Now, as you could see, it's in the foreground. So as we just looked at, what we can do is send it backward. See how it brings it back one step behind the fireball. And then we're gonna send it backward one more time so that it's behind the character. Now, what I'd like to do is line it up with the fireball or glowing sphere, bring this up a little bit. And then the only other thing I did was I brought the transparency down to roughly about 45-ish, between 40 to 50, it's really up to you. I didn't want it to be so dominant and so prominent. So now you see that it's got a few more of these glowing rays coming out of it. And that's the look that I really wanted. Lastly, I gave it some text here. And again, we're just going to copy and paste this over. And for the Canva logo, I just searched in Elements for Canva, and you'll get the Canva logo in white and also in its actual colors. This particular font is called Aliens in Cal. You know, if you ever watch the movie Aliens, it kind of has that look to it. So I thought it fit very well. I think it's a very simple but effective and straight to the point type of design. Now, if you like this video, I'm going to talk about another way you can utilize layers to kind of get a pop-out effect, or that effect where it looks like the object is going through something. I'm working on that video, so stay tuned. And if it's not up, that just means that I'm editing it, but it'll be something for you to look forward to. As always, I appreciate you checking out the video. Get out there, hit record, create, and I'll see you when I see you.